Hello everyone, this is Gangnam de-twix again. I'm going to be doing a walkthrough over the next couple months of Dying Light on Nightmare Mode. This is the following edition, so it's all the DLCs plus the additional the following game. And I will be playing that as well on Nightmare Mode. As you can see from here, the first mission I beat was just the day one first assignment. That I would have played and recorded, but I didn't think anyone would enjoy watching me kick a zombie to death for 10 minutes, because in Nightmare Mode, the zombies are ridiculously difficult to kill. So, for the first mission I'm going to be recording, though, it's going to be the Mother Day's mission. So, first we have to get to Gazi's place. One thing that I've always loved about Dying Light is the open world aspect, the parkour aspect of it. And normally, I would actually be fighting these zombies, but because of the difficulty level in the Nightmare Mode and my low level currently, it's not something I'm totally trying to pursue, because it's more than likely going to get me killed, actually, instead of helping me manage to survive. He's in the window and there's just a break. So one thing about Nightmare Mode, for those of you who have never played it, or have never played Dying Light. It's a pretty difficult game mode. You have very little stamina. It takes multiple hits to the head to be able to beat a zombie to death. It's just much more difficult around your med pack rather than healing you immediately. It's a long time to apply their healing effect. Normally they do it one by one, so it's like for 1 second, you get one health, maybe two or three health. So normally you have to be running. You can't stay in the fight and just use the ability.
Thank you.
So, and this was a full health pike branch for me. Okay, so let me see. What's he getting? 101 bucks? I can convert that into some better weapons, so that was worth it. Also, for those of you who have never played this before, I highly recommend it, but if you get it, I really recommend the following edition. One, it's just kind of the base edition now. It's the easiest one to find. It's a little more expensive than the normal one, but it's way funner. You can get cars, you get access to a bunch of really cool skins. Like currently I'm wearing the Joker skin, which I'll show you when I make it to a safe house. For those of you who are wondering currently why I'm not totally doing the mission, in order to stay competitive in this mode and have a chance to stay alive, you're gonna have to take the time to upgrade, like in every mission, by using the spikes effectively, by getting as many bonus points as you can. You can try running around at night, but in this mode, running around at night is completely and totally a death wish. So that did not work out how I wanted it to. So normally in this, on a regular mode, I wouldn't use the spike fences or spike garbage cans to instant kill zombies that often. Oh sweet, it actually teleported me to a safe zone I hadn't explored before. But in this, again, because of the difficulty of the zombies, you always have to try to stay 2 or 3 steps ahead of them with level. Particularly until you can unlock what I call the curb stomp ability, which is when you can... Zombies, come on, come on. Which is when you can kick a zombie that you've stunned or knocked onto the ground. There we go. Firecrackers. But until you get that ability, it's pretty difficult to kill zombies. Even with like this wrench, which is pretty hardcore, but even then, it's gonna take me extremely long to do what I need to do. So you really have to get your fighting power up very, very quickly. You have to always be trying to outthink the zombies, not getting trapped in horde areas where they can all rush you. Always make sure you have a vehicle in the area that you can jump up on, like I was just doing. Okay, so where is this mother stair quest? Where is this place that it spawned me? It spawned me on the wrong side of the map. Well, actually, I guess it didn't. I was gonna have to go through that tunnel either way, I guess. So let's see. I do not believe this is the tunnel that we have to blow a hole in to be able to use, but I could be wrong. About to find out here in a second. No, this is the one with the bus in the middle. So normally there are some fairly difficult zombies in here, which is why I'm just going to sprint through as quickly as possible. One other thing in this that makes it more difficult is you actually have a limited amount of stamina. So as you're running, you'll start to slow down, your screen will black out, and if you're not careful, you'll be running just being able to view a sliver of the screen. Hopefully. Or it'll just accomplish in me wasting a Molotov cocktail. But nope. Not the case. That's some upgrade points. I am planning on doing a couple night runs during these walkthroughs. Not that many, just because when you saw me die just from a pack of normal zombies in the daytime trying to upgrade myself. Trying to do that at night is going to be completely and totally suicidal. But just to show you the effect that nighttime has in this game, particularly on nightmare mode, I am going to go through and do a couple walkthroughs running around and trying to upgrade myself during that time. So make sure you stick around and stay tuned. I regularly update the channel, so I'll be putting stuff on as often as I can. This one.
Ozzy, is anybody in here?
So for those of you who don't know, we're finding Ghazi because the leader of the tower, which is the group we're currently working for.
Ghazi, are you there?
No, not his house. Third time's charm.
If mama ain't...
Ghazi? No, Michael, can I...
Alright, skip cutscene. Oh, skip cutscene. Yeah, bye-bye. Okay, so I need to find what for Ghazi? I need to get a special box, chocolate, and find the Charlie tape. Okay, so we need his anti-seizure medication he has, because the leader of the tower was beat by one of the other groups in the area that we'll learn more about as we go through the walkthrough. If you guys have already played the game, you know exactly who I'm talking about and who beat him up. But for those of you who don't, I won't spoil the surprise. Okay, but we will meet him here eventually, and I will be sure to point him out when that occurs. But yeah, for right now, he's got swelling in his head, and we need anti-seizure meds so that he can... pretty much so that he can, we can make sure he doesn't die. So that's currently my mission, is to find these meds for him in order to help him and keep the tower unified under him as their leader. Sweet. I was hoping for something better than that, but okay. So one thing that does make this game easier, particularly in this mode, is being able to upgrade and get special weapons as quickly as possible, which I'll be trying to do as I go throughout these walkthroughs. But currently it's just so early in the game, I haven't totally had time to be able to obtain these weapons and to upgrade them like I need to. But yeah, for those of you wondering, this is my third playthrough of this game. First one on YouTube, though, since I recently started with my channel. If you subscribe to my channel, if you look at my other videos, a lot of them are MOBAs, Paragon in particular, and also zombie slash horror games. So, Resident Evil 7 Biohazard is one that I've currently been playing quite a bit. I'm going to be resuming that series here soon. I took a bit of a break from it to do some Paragon deck challenge videos. And now I'm going to be adding Dying Light. Come on, die already. So, for those of you who are wondering how difficult Nightmare Mode is, that is how difficult it is. This is probably one of the most powerful wrenches I'm going to be getting in the game right now. And it literally took me about 10 hits and a bunch of kicks. Okay, so I hope some of you saw how my screen kind of started blurring and blacking out there when I was running around for too long. Particularly if I'm jumping. If I jump and kick, it uses up a pretty substantial amount of stamina as well. So in general, I try to avoid doing that as much as possible. But sometimes you just gotta do it, particularly when the newly churned zombies make it in the runners and stuff. It gets really difficult. So maybe I'll be kidding there. Firecracker time. Here we go, run, follow the noise. I need to get in. Quick, lift it. Up high someplace. So normally in the normal game, you'd probably have about 20 medkits or so. In this, you're going to be lucky to find enough resources to find that. Or even to build it or craft it. So you really have to be careful with your health, with your med packs. You're going to sleep a lot in this just because you're going to get damaged so much. And you may not want to use a health pack because you may not know if you're going to be able to get another one later on. You gotta follow me. Get away from the house I need to get into. I really wish I had a Molotov cocktail now, actually. Is there anything I can blow up? It doesn't look right. This is gonna be a death trap if I can't open this door. Okay, perfect. Open. Get me through here. Okay, so somewhere around here is one thing you need for his mother. I'm not entirely certain if it's the chocolate or the tape. I guess we'll find out. After I lead these zombies on a merry chase. So I did already upgrade the ability of when I throw a throwing star or a flaming star, it hits three different enemies rather than just one. It allows me to conserve how many throwing stars I'm using as well as increasing the elemental effect. So, early on in Nightmare Mode, there's a lot of just this kicking, because all I'm going to wind up doing is breaking weapons or exhausting myself in the process of trying to kill them. Oh, perfect. Do you have what I need to?
All gone in a heartbeat.
Excuse me?
Would you look at me?
Can I look in here? Ooh, sweet. You don't mind if I do this, do you? Success.
No? You do not blame me, but I am. You see, I was. Almost every gasoline station in Haran I owned. And when they announced the global...
Oh, you must have been really rich, dude.
...games, it was supposed to be like...
Okay, here we go. I hope I get some alcohol or something to make a bomb. And can't make a lacerator yet because I don't have the correct weapons. Okay, so somewhere in there is exactly what I'm looking for. The problem's going to be trying to get in there and then get back out without getting killed. Can I rig any of these to blow up? No. Oh man. Get going. Seeing as you can see right now, the med kit's taking forever to heal me. I wish this train was still running, I could lure them all to the track. But I guess that would mean someone has to be alive to run it, so there's that problem. How in the world did you get up here? Nice. So really, I mean, playing in this mode, to me, this is much more of like the zombie effect kind of is what you get in this. Just because you're running around so much, you're trying to escape. You can't actually stand and fight like you could in the other modes. What do I got? Drop kick, vault. Vault comes in handy. Yeah, I'm gonna go with vault. I need to be able to escape when I need to and jump over the zombies if I need to. Perfect. Okay, I definitely don't want to get a fight with the big guy. Oh, crap. Get out. Okay. Here we go again. Get another shot. I cannot wait to unlock camouflage later on. Search. Nothing. Maybe it's in the fridge. Ooh, burger. I can eat that for some health. There we go. Box of chocolates. Perfect. Got it. I'm gonna get up here. Someone's about to jump on me. Okay, sweet. Now all we need is the Charlie tape. And this is over. Okay, so the Charlie tape is here, and it's always really fun trying to get in. And I can never remember how to get in. Every time I play this game, I have to relearn. So it's just right in there. It's just trying to get them to open up. Do none of the zombies see me right now? I'm totally okay if that's the case. Okay, I got lockpick the door. I don't like how close that ground is. Yeah, someone's literally right behind me. Couldn't dodge out of the way quick enough. Use my last med kit, I guess. Oh wait, you got a gun? $19. Come on, it should give me the baton. At least could have done something with that. So, let me see. I still don't have any alcohol to make a med kit, so I'm gonna have to raid the store once I get back from this.
Son of a bitch, not now!
Yeah, shut the door. Turn off the alarm. And
Charlie. Hope. See you for Charlie.
And hope beyond hope that the crazies don't find me. X, Y, D, L, J, B. Man, I'm forgetting the alphabet here, guys. C.
Gotcha.
Good to go. Let's go give Mama back this stuff. Okay, these guys are really fun under the right conditions, but I'm not gonna blow them up because I do not want to attract a ton of runners because of the noise. I think there's a bunch of runners in here, but we're gonna find out. If there are, I'm gonna be booking it like a madman. Okay, it doesn't look like it yet. It's blocked off, of course. Okay, it's not gonna become my grave. Death trap. Back on the freeway to get back. Here we go. But yeah, for you guys who are veterans of this game that play Be the Zombie, play Night Hunt modes, during my walkthrough I have that disabled, but I'd be more than willing to play with anyone. Just drop me your gamer tag in a comment, whatever you want to do. But yeah, it's a fun to do multiplayer on here. For those of you who haven't done it, I'd highly recommend it. It's really fun being the zombie. It's really fun working together to try to kill it. It's super hard too, which is nice. It's really competitive. It's kind of, for me, it's got not totally a MOBA feel, but a little bit of a MOBA feel, just because you're using weapons you actually have, you're using perks and traits that you really have. So really you get to build your character that's going to be versing everyone. And then whoever's the zombie is just a total psycho and just gets to kill everyone. So, that's the extent of that. Stamina here, I gotta get off this freeway. Perfect. With any luck, I'm gonna see these zombies start dropping from the sky here. Ooh, man, that was really close. I got lucky. I was about to be my second death on one video. I would be very ashamed of that, actually. Okay, let me in, let me in. Here you go, Gazi. I got it. I got everything. I hope you're happy. I hope the tower's happy. Yeah. Open up.
Here's your movie and your chocolates. Right. Hey, then I'll just let myself in through the roof.
Well, then, he decided not to let me in. It's a roof, roof. What can I grab onto to get on this roof? I sadly can't climb that. That's the one thing your character cannot do in this game. I'll just jump from roof to roof. See if I can make this. No. Notice, for those of you who never played this game, make sure to turn your volume up highly. Like, the sound effects that you hear that don't even have anything to do with the zombie are super creepy. Around me, you'll just hear like a scream out of the blue or something like that. It has nothing to do with the zombie being in your area. It's just little random things that the creators threw into the game. And I mean, I love it. It's super fun to hear. It really keeps you on the edge of your seat. Huh, how am I supposed to get here? Some tells me that's how. Get in the freeway. I gotta climb all the way over there without falling. And then hop from that onto the roof, it looks like. Well, this will be fun. Like I said, it's been, since, even though this is my third walkthrough of the game, there's so much in this game, so many side missions, I totally forget them from time to time. Just like this mission. Do you remember how I got up there, how I got on the roof? I think last time I did it, it took me like 10 minutes. I'm really hoping that's not going to be the case this time, guys. But if anything, I hope this shows you that I'm not scripting this thing. I really have no idea what I'm doing right now. Ugh. come on, that's your lip. That's not be on fire. Okay, I gotta get way back up there. Wait, is there anything in the back of this, though? Oh, wait, if it's a hard lockpick, I don't got time for that right now. Oh, come on, dude. Why couldn't you just let me in? Why you gotta make me do all this? Why you gotta make me chase you? Back up on the freeway. Come here, zombie. If I knock money on the ground, goodness, none of them are going down. See, this is also the difficult part with playing this at this low of a level is just the amount of zombies that are in it. The lack of weaponry, lack of Molotov cocktails, because I really trust in those later on. Those and grenades. And one other thing is guns. Normally people would say, well, if you use a gun, you're going to get yourself killed because you're going to attract all the zombies, which is true. You're going to attract a bunch of volatiles, a bunch of runners that are going to be able to run you down and kill you. The difference is in this mode, the melee weapons are so ineffective normally that you pretty much have to use guns to be able to get through. Which adds a whole nother element, because literally all the zombies are going to know exactly where you are almost all the time. And I got a bunch of gauze. I've never had this much gauze before. Normally I'm looking for that, and I got a bunch of alcohol with my character. Don't blew up. I didn't cause it. Okay, so guys, this is my first volatile. These guys are always fun. They move super fast. They think they are very difficult to kill and probably going to be even more so in this mode. Since I'm playing nightmare mode, they don't pop up on my mini-map either. Because normally you'd have a arrow that's white, yellow, or red, depending upon if they know you're there or not. For me, I don't have one. It's nightmare. I just get to watch them climb up the bus and try to kill me. And hope no one else is in the area. Come on, bring it on. Try to get back up. But sooner or later, this will kill her. It just takes a really long time. But these are one of the things that, outside of the special ones that run around in the middle of the night, which will probably be in the next mission I do, it'll be a story mission. These are probably the most deadly zombies that you will bump into. Come on. There we go. Nope. You're gonna go down. I'm determined. You're not gonna make it up here. There we go. Perfect. Search, because normally these people have got really good stuff. So the house is pretty much right under us right now. So I just need to find a way to get down there. And I wonder if I just gotta hop on this side. Okay, I need to not fall off right now. Guy's house is under me. How am I supposed to get there? Oh, perfect ladder. This works. Please use the ladder. But probably my favorite upgrade I can get in this, I would say, is Man, no, I just forgot the name of it. Can't be my favorite, I guess, if I can't remember the name. You get a grappling hook, that's what it's called. And that is probably my favorite upgrade because it lets you get out of trouble really quick. It lets you get out of areas that are super dangerous. You can jump up and grab ledges, so I could just jump up and grab the ledge rather than going through this whole entire ring around the Rosie type stuff. And, but that took me less time to figure out than last time, and you guys got to see a Volatole in case you've never seen one before. Water pipe and more coffee, so I can sell the coffee for some do-re-mi. So, Gazi, I need that stuff that you promised me. I need it real bad. And I'm gonna take it if you don't give it to me. Where are you? Okay, normally I would say Molotov cocktail, but I need a med kit more than I need the Molotov cocktail, and apparently I'm missing some of the Molotov cocktail as well. So, that's not even an option. What in the world?
The movie I thought. Mama's watching.
I forgot his buckethead mom. World's best mom. You got some interesting skills, dude. I mean, it's quite the thing of flower there.
Is Mama happy?
Well, then I hope Mom's happy.
Yeah, thank
guys.
Hey, skip through. Good, good, good. Collect the anti-seizure meds. Perfect. Tranquilizers. I don't know. I did not really think of that as anti-seizure meds, but hey, I could be wrong. Okay, guys, I feel bad for you, sir. But hey, you will live a long, happy life. In there with your buckethead mom. Okay, so I gotta get out the way I came in. Oh well. Okay, now I need to take the medicine back to the tower. And then collect my reward, buy some resources, sell some weapons. And that'll probably be the conclusion of this first video. But I'll continue narrating till I get there, and then I'll give my parting remarks, guys. I know for some people, when they find out I'm playing this, they're going to be asking me, hey, why are you playing this? It's a older game. But part of it is the main focus of my channel is MOBAs, undead zombie horror games. And like I said, I have my Resident Evil, but I took a little bit of a break from that to do some Paragon stuff, and I always really wanted to get this going. This to me is one of the definitive zombie type experiences that I think are really gonna mold and have been molding zombie games for the rest of eternity, really. As long as there's video games around, I feel like a lot of them are gonna be trying to copy this or probably trying to copy The Last of Us. And I may do a walkthrough of that if I get some requests for it. If not, I probably won't. I beat the game about 4 times on every mode. But I'd be willing to play normal mode or do the hardest mode. I mean, if I got enough demand for it and people would watch it and I knew that they would, I would definitely do that. But I'm hoping just to get more word out there on the zombie game for the PS4. I don't see a lot about their zombie games the majority of the time on YouTube or anywhere else, really. But really, I mean, PS4 to me has some of the funnest zombie games that are out there. Ooh, I can save a guy. Where is he? Get off him! Oh, such foul language.
Keep no rushing hands off me!
There, that's what I want, that curb stomp.
Bastards to hell.
Well, thank you. 18 bucks, I'll take that. And a bit more to level 4. Getting closer and closer all the time. The light trap really only works, sadly, when it's nighttime. I've tried it during the daytime, it does not do too much. Okay, and I really hope that thing thudding and breaking open was not a, runner. I don't know if that's the official name. That's just always what I've called them. I mean, they call them volatiles too, but there's so many different volatiles in this game that it's difficult for me to just say, oh, there's a volatile over there, because you may not know what it is. You may not see it, maybe. So I'm just going to call them runners. If you don't like it, I'm sorry. It's going to happen. Go watch a different video. Different one of mine, of course. So don't go watch someone else play this game. I need your betrayal and your views. I'll secure that later when I actually have a reason to. But yeah, this video I'll probably release in a one part. Normally, I'm going to try to make it so the missions don't take quite this long. I may release it in two parts, I'm not sure. But this is a good 30-minute video, and I know it's tough to get through 30 minutes of footage time from time to time. Oh man, I just ran out of health. I gotta be careful and not do that again. I mean stamina, not health. But like I said, this game, I put hours into it. After I beat this game and every mission, I'll be continuing the walkthrough, playing the following on Nightmare Mode. And that one gets really crazy because you have a buggy. You can move around, you can be mobile. You don't got nothing for me. Come on, dude.
Sometimes I feel like there's nothing outside.
Let's ride the elevator up. Going upstairs, moving up in the world. I know, please wait. The tower. Also, I gotta say, one thing that I always really loved in this was actually the loading screen. I mean, that may seem like a pretty small part. But I mean, how many loading screens do you see that as it loads, you see the shimmering, you see the light pop up, you see the outlines of zombies, and you're jumping through the air practically. The zombies are under you reaching up with their hands. I always just thought that was one of the coolest things in the game. How are you downstairs? Oh yeah, there's stairs that goes down. Haha. Let's grow a brain, Michael. Come on, grow a brain.
Right, I've got your anti-seizure. Well, he may be.
Did you?
Yeah.
Good job, good job. I would watch this with you, but YouTube's gonna get mad at me if I do, so I apologize. Ooh, sweet champion. I can turn that into some pretty nice stuff. Okay, so up here, there's a store. I'm gonna buy some junk from them, and then the video will be concluded until the next one.
Something's going on.
I don't have spare keys for 202. Okay, that's very nice. I just want to trade. I'll start that mission later. Sell all, sell cigarettes, buy. Oh, come on, you. I guess I haven't slept. I could have swore I slept since the last time I played this, but I guess not. This claw hammer is really tempting. Yeah, I'm gonna buy it.
What's the government
I need
doing?
Some better stuff. And actually, I'm going to sell him some weapons to make some money back, too, off that. Sweet. So the claw hammer and my rusty wrench will probably be my mains here, apart from the rebar. But the rebar has its own time to be used. That's not now. Okay, so that is the conclusion of this first walkthrough for Dying Light. I hope you enjoyed it. I'm going to be posting a lot more, particularly over spring break here in about a week and a half. I'll be doing a lot of videos during that time. I'll have a lot more time on my hand to do them. Be sure to stay tuned. Hit me up with a subscribe, a like, a comment. And be sure to check out my other videos. I got some videos for Paragon, which is a MOBA for PS4. And three videos of Resident Evil so far, Biohazard. So... have a great rest of your day, guys, and God bless.